Here I just want to talk about the process for doing a rendering with a transparent background. And that can be useful for a number of reasons. Typically, if you're doing a rendering that's going to be included on some kind of a poster layout, you might want only the object and not its background to be rendered out so that you can put it on top of things. And also, if you're doing any kind of compositing work where you're trying to put a rendering of a 3D object on top of a real photograph, you don't want any kind of background there. PhotoWorks actually makes this pretty easy, but there's a couple things you need to know. So I'm going to look at our scene settings here in PhotoWorks. And what you need to do is you need to get rid of all the room stuff for one thing, because you have to have the object kind of floating out in space without anything around it. So you need to uncheck the floor and walls if they are checked here. But the most important thing is in back and foreground here, you want to put the background not to plain, unless you really do want a white mat, but you want to put it to none. Okay? So once we do that, and let me just do a test rendering here. Okay, so it looks quite dark now because it's showing that no background is black, but don't worry about that at the moment. So in order to do a nice rendering to a file to use in Photoshop or something, remember, we first want to turn up our anti-aliasing settings. And then we want to use render to file. So I'll just do a okay. So I've got a place on my disk where I'm going to render this out to. You cannot use a JPEG image for this. What you want to do, the best bet is to use a TIFF. And notice that it says RGBA TIFF here. That means that in addition to getting your 8 bits of R, G, and B information each, you're also getting 8 bits of alpha information, which is that transparency that we can use to get rid of the background in Photoshop. So RGBA TIFF here. And just to save time, I'm going to do this fairly small. I'll do it at like 640 by 480. Obviously, if you were going to print, you would want to do much larger there. Compress using run length encoding is just fine. That's not destructive for a TIFF, so it just makes the file smaller without harming the image at all. Okay, so now that I've got that set, I'll go ahead and hit render. And our rendering is done. So at this point, we can go and switch over to Photoshop. And let me load up that image. Okay. Now, notice that in Photoshop here, when we load it up, we don't see a black background, we see this checkered background. And that's what we accomplished by saying no background in those scene settings and then rendering to an RGBA TIFF document. So what this means is that it's only the object that we're seeing, and if you zoom up here, you see that it's got a nice partially transparent anti-aliased edge here. So that's going to make it very easy to position this on top of something else. Just to show you an example of that, I'm just going to go and select this object. I don't even have to be very precise about this because all this is transparent, so I'm going to copy that, and then I just found a picture of someone's desk. I'll paste this, and you see that it's making a very nice, it's blending in very nicely with the background there. The edge, I'm not getting any weird jaggy or fringe edges there. So if I wanted to try to composite this onto this desk, let's see. Well, we need to make it smaller for one thing. Okay. And there you go. Not a very good compositing, but at least we don't have problems with weird edges showing up and infringing and stuff like that. So that's the process for doing a transparent background rendering in PhotoWorks, and that can be very useful for when you're using your renderings in other compositions.